There's not a whole lot of great outcrop at Fort Mason, but if you walk down the stairs and go past the festival pavilion and cross the little chain link fence, there's a couple of really giant wood chairs, and right there is this outcrop. This is an outcrop of sandstone, and that sandstone is very, very, very lightly metamorphosed, what geologists would call prehnite pumpilite facies metamorphism, which is like the next best thing to not being metamorphosed at all. And it's the same kind of rock that we find just over there at Alcatraz Island. This is part of the Alcatraz terrain that underlies downtown San Francisco as well. There's a couple neat things to notice here. One that will immediately catch your eye are these weird little boxy looking shapes on the outcrop surface. And you'll notice that they're not quite at sea level and not up above sea level, but at this little zone that's about a meter or two above sea level. This is a form of weathering called tuffoni. It's an Italian name, and other people call it honeycomb weathering. So it's got these little tiny cells like in a honeycomb, in a beehive. But it's a kind of weathering here that is frequent in sandstones along the Central California coast, and it's caused by slight differences in weathering rates, making little pockets. And then salt water gets into those little pockets, the water evaporates, and salt crystals penetrate into the rock, breaking it apart, making it fall apart more rapidly. So the little concavities become more exaggerated through time. There's also some neat features that are not on the surface of the rock, but part of the rock itself. The rock here is shot through with a whole bunch of different veins. And these veins are cracks in the rock that have been healed with mineral deposits. And some of the veins here are white in color, probably milky quartz, maybe some feldspar in there. And other of the veins here are black. And we're not sure what the black ones are, but they might be a really exciting form of fault glass. When an earthquake moves along a fault, it generates frictional heating, and that heating is very localized, but it can melt the rock on either side of the fault surface. So, boom, the earthquake moves, suddenly that rock gets flash heated, it melts, making a fault glass that has chilled exceptionally rapidly. So these black fault rocks here are potentially a sort of fossil earthquake.